talking.
Thank you, but no. I'm sorry, we weren't properly introduced at the Beacon the other night.
Yes, I left early.
Yes. Oh, some flowers from our gardens.
Oh, they're lovely. Thank you.
It's a lonely spot.
Well, I fell in love with the place as soon as I saw it.
Stone walls?
More than that. It's history.
But not your history.
Perhaps it'll grow to be mine.
I'll leave you to get on. I hope you find your happiness, or whatever it is you're looking for at Castle Carla.
Well, I don't think I'm looking for anything.
No? Goodbye, Miss McAllister.
Goodbye, Lady Fleming.
Lady Fleming.
Oh. The Laird's mother.
What'd she want?
I think she was giving me the once over.
She certainly chooses her moments.
Do you ride, Miss McAllister?
Yes.
Good. I'll call by tomorrow. I'd like to show you the country.
Oh, I don't have a horse.
I'll lend you one of mine.
I really should be working.
Well, everyone's entitled to a break. I've taken one myself.
All right.
Excellent. I'll pick you up about 10:30. Bye for now, Miss McAllister.
Goodbye, Mr. Fleming.
All this.
Paul.
I've wondered about Paul. You want to talk?
I can't. Especially not to you.
Not to me. Why? He He's married, isn't he?
Oh, Sarah, please, just leave it.
No, Janie, I will not just...
He loves me, Sarah.
Well, of course he does. And his wife, I suppose she thinks he loves her as well. Or does she already know?
I wouldn't know. I've never been a wife. You've been a wife, you tell me.
All right. So, when's the wedding? To be more precise, the divorce followed by the wedding.
Just as soon as the children.
Oh, the children. Oh, God, Janie, what have you gotten yourself into?
I love him, Sarah, and he loves me. That's all that matters.
You really believe that?
I knew it was pointless talking to you. You don't understand. That's where we're different. I'm not afraid to face reality.
What's that supposed to mean?
Oh, please, Sarah, I don't want to fight.
What are you gonna do?
Wait till he calls. And go running. I can't help it. I don't want to spend the rest of my life an old maid in a castle. Do you?
I don't know what I want. Oh, baby.
Canride.
Oh, sort of. Do you expect me to fall off?
No. We'll stop for the picnic at the meeting. All right?
All right.
What did you call it? The meeting?
Uh-huh.
Why?
Well, all the country around here is bound up in an old legend about Laurie Fraser and my forebear, the Lord of the Glen. And this is where they were reputed to meet, where he had his wicked way with her.
Laurie Fraser and how many others?
I'm sorry about the Knight of the Beacon.
Sorry?
But I kissed you. I really don't know what possessed me. I don't usually kiss women I've not yet been introduced to.
You don't?
Right, come on, let's eat.
What a sad story. Lady Laurie and all those long, lonely nights.
Oh, you know it already, do you?
Well, there was one of your books back at the hotel.
Ah.
Or did you just make that all up?
Certainly not. I'm a reputable Edinburgh publisher.
Are you really the Lord of the Glen?
No. Well, yes, actually. That is, my family are descendants. We don't use the title. There's nothing that goes with it. The feudal perks, for instance, like money or horses or virgins.
Sounds tough.
Why don't you use your husband's name?
What?
Well, we all call you Miss McAllister, but you're really Mrs. Hunter, aren't you?
Yes. I use my own name for the gallery, somehow. How did you know about my husband?
Georgie told me. She knows most things.
Georgie. Now, she came as Nelson to the Beacon, right?
That's Georgie.
You don't approve?
No, I do. She's quite a relief, actually. They all like to think they know everything about you. This is a small community. She said your husband was a fine painter.
Yes, he was. He was a fine painter.
Or if you'd rather not talk about it.
No, I'd rather not. It was all a long time ago. What about you? Never married?
No.
Georgina told me.
I won't marry. Until I meet the woman I know I must marry, but I can't avoid marrying. I won't marry until I meet the person that I know that I can spend the rest of my life with. Satisfied?
Yes.
Good. Sister's gone away.
Phone tapping.
Our village gossip.
Yes, she's gone away to London. Now what do I do?
Just wait.
I have been.
So you're on your own enough at the castle. Is that not, where are you?
Should it?
Well, it's a bit lonely, I would have thought.
I like it.
Uh-huh.
I like my own company.
Well, if you ever feel like coming down to Edinburgh...
Someday.
Wind it in, wind it in.
Thank you.
No, damn it. You lost it.
It got away? What a clever old fish.
Go in peace, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you, and remain with you always.